Good morning, children. So today we are going to do recap session, right? I'll be going to ask few questions to you all and you all are going to answer. Okay, children? So let's start, children. My first question is, yes, boys mostly you all have a toy car, right, children? So toy car and a normal car, it is a living thing or a non-living thing? Who is going to answer? Yes, yes, anyone, anyone, anyone. Yes. So children, what is the correct answer? Car is a non-living thing. Now, another question raised in my mind, that we always say that living things can move from one place to another place, right? Car is also going to move. But what is the difference, children? You are going to, yes, you are going to start your car. Yes or no? Then will drive a car and then only it is going to move. So in non-living things, they will move, but they will not move on its own. Yes, while living things will move on its own. That is a difference. I hope it is clear now, children. Yes? Okay. My second question is, can anyone give me examples of living things? Yes? Can you give me examples of living things? Anyone, 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 anyone. Come on, come on, come on. Who is going to try? Yes, yes, yes. Will be the answer. Yes, children. So what are the examples of living things, children? We human beings, plants, animals, birds. These all are the examples of living things. Okay, my third question is, children, potato is there, right? Potato is a living thing or a non-living thing? Yes, anyone, anyone is going to. Yes, you can give me the answer. Yes, anyone. You can try, children. Yes, yes, yes. Who is going to answer? So, children, what is the correct answer? Potato is a living thing or a non-living thing? Potato is a living thing, children. Yes. From seed, plant is going to grow, and from plant, plant is going to get converted into a tree. So plants do grow, right? So they are considered as living things. So potato is also a living thing. Is it clear, children? Yes. Okay. Now give me a few examples of non-living things. Who is going to give me the answer? Yes, anyone, anyone, anyone. Yes, 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 anyone? Yes, anyone will try? Okay. So yes, what are the examples of non-living things, children? Pen, pencil, laptop, table, so many examples are there. Yes, children, it is clear to you all? Yes. Okay, children, then my next question is, what is the difference between living things and non-living things? Who is going to give me the answer now? Come on, who is going to give the answer? Come on, children, be a little bit quick. Yes, 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 I'm waiting. Any difference? Yes, yes, anyone? Yes. So children, what will be the correct answer? What is the difference between living and non-living thing? We had already discussed about it. Living things can grow while non-living things, they do not grow. Yes. Then living things need food, water and shelter. Non-living things, they don't need such things, right? Living things breathe. Non-living things do not breathe, right, children? Then we have living things reproduce. Non-living things do not reproduce. They will not reproduce. They will not produce their own babies. Right, children? Then, living things we have feelings. We can feel. They do not feel. They will not be able to feel. Right, children? Living things die. They will die. And non-living things will not die. One more important point, children. Living things will move from one place to another place. Non-living things will not be able to move on its own. Is it clear, children? These all are the difference between living and non-living things. Now, can anyone tell me what is the difference between living and non-living? What answer will come, children? You can give the same answer, children, right? One difference you can give, that they can eat, they can grow, they'll not be able to eat, they'll not be able to grow. Yes, children, this we can include. So again, the same answer will come, okay? Now, children, my question is, what is a difference between plant and animal? Can anyone tell me any one simple difference? Right now only we had discussed. Can anyone tell me what is the difference between that? Anyone? Yes, children, come on. Okay, I will help you, children. Yes, what is the correct answer? Correct answer is, children, plants. Yes, children, their parts are going to move. Correct, children? That plant or that tree is not going to move from one place to another place. Right? While animals, they can easily move on its own from one place to another place. This is the major difference between plants and animals. Yes, children? Okay, now next question. Okay. Okay, the next question is, children, are all living things man-made? I'll repeat my question. And are all living things, yes, are all living things man-made? Is it a correct question, children? I just wanted to know. We cannot create anything, right, children? So no. Okay, living, non-living things, man can make, right? So many non-living things are there which is made by men, children. Yes or no? Yes. Then, children, are all natural things living? That is my question. Like clouds, rains, volcanoes, they are considered as living or non-living thing, children? What will happen? Yes, are all natural things living? Can we consider them as a living thing? No, children. These things which is created by nature, it is not possible that every time whatever things are created by God, it is in living condition. We all can breathe, right, children? We all can grow, everything can happen. But clouds, you will be able to see. When you will be able to see? During this season, during monsoon season. Yes or no, children? They can breathe, they can eat. So natural things and man-made things, these two things are different, children. And when we talk about living and non-living things, what difference is there, that we had already discussed, okay? Now, next question. Okay, suppose there is a spoon, right, children? You have a stainless steel or spoon, or what spoon is there in your hand, right, children? It is made up of plastic, it is made up of steel. It is a living thing or a non-living thing? It is a non-living thing. That thing is not going to move on its own. Spoon, when you are going to move, it is going to move from one place to another place. That thing is clear, right, children? Okay, we have discussed about, children, one plant, mimosa plant. What do you mean by mimosa plant? Can anyone tell me what do you mean by mimosa plant? Yes, children, mimosa plant, that is also called as Mimosa pudica. Children, this is a type of plant, we had discussed about it. It is also called as touch me not plant. So when you are going to touch that plant, the leaves are going to get drawn down. Again, it will be in proper condition. Yes, again it is going to open up. Yes, children, again it is going to open up. So, plants, yes, they are also going to show some time of movement. We had already discussed about it. Yes, and this is a sensitive plant. So the moment you are going to touch, it is going to show what changes are going to happen, that it is going to show. So we had discussed about it, children. I hope now living things and non-living things, everything is clear to you all, children. In detail, we had discussed the lesson, and today we had done a recap and we had an interactive session. Okay, children. Thank you, children. Have a nice day. Stay safe.